For this lesson, we will be creating the bench seat from the train station scene we've seen in earlier lessons. Start in a new 3ds Max scene. We need to change the unit setup to match the train station scene, since we will need to eventually merge both files together. Go to the Customize menu, Unit Setup, Change to Generic Units. In the System Unit Setup, make sure one unit equals 1 inch, as this is what is used in the train station scene. Now OK the dialog box. Start in the Command Panel. Create Geometry Box. If you know the exact size and location you want the box, you can create the object using the rollout keyboard entry. Leave the X, Y, and Z values at 0 to create the box at the center of the scene. Change the length to 115, the width to 53, and the height to 20. Make sure the perspective viewport is selected, then click the Create button. Right-click on the box and in the Transform section of the quad menu, choose Convert to Editable Poly. Or you could instead go to the ribbon and in the Poly Modeling panel, choose Convert to Poly. These tools are both accessible in the Modify panel and the Modeling ribbon. As a matter of fact, both tools can be found in both locations, though the ribbon often contains additional features. So in this lesson, we will concentrate primarily using the Modeling ribbon. When modeling, press F4 to turn on Edged Faces mode to see the subobject better. Let's start at the polygon subobject level, which you can access in the ribbon or by right-clicking and going to the Tool 1 section of the quad menu. Select the polygon at the top of the box. A subobject turns red when you select it. In the case of selected polygons, you can press F2 to toggle the shading on and off. For this lesson, we want to leave it on. In the ribbon, go to Polygons. Click the arrow next to the Inset tool to access the Settings button. This will bring up the caddy. Change the inset amount to 15, then click the check mark to OK the caddy. What the inset has done is create a new polygon that is inset into the old polygon. Go again to Polygons. Click the arrow next to the Extrude tool to access the Settings button. By default, Extrude has an amount of 10. Change it to 25. Click the check mark to OK the caddy. Now orbit the perspective viewport so that you can see the bottom polygon and select it. Instead of using Inset and then Extrude, we'll use Bevel since it will essentially do both. Select the arrow next to the Bevel tool to access the Settings button. Change the height to 0 and outline amount to -3. But instead of pressing the check, click on the plus sign, which OKs the change but allows you to continue using the bevel. Now change the outline amount to 0 and the height to 5. Now select the check mark to OK this dialog. So the rough shape for the seat is done, and now it needs to be refined. The original seat model has curved sides and is very smooth. A tool that can achieve this is NURMS, which means Non-Uniform Rational Mesh Smooth. NURMS will round over corners and edges as if they have been filed or planed smooth. In the ribbon, Edit Panel, click on the NURMS button. The seat will smooth out but lose some detail and definition. The way we can add back some lost detail is by adding or even removing polygons. You should still be in polygon mode, but if not, go to the ribbon and select polygon. Click the NURMS button to turn it off. Select the bottom polygon on the seat and press delete to remove it. Click the NURMS button again to turn smoothing back on. See how the side is now straight, but the overall shape is still curved? Now turn NURMS off again. Delete the edge below the seat by selecting one polygon, hold Shift, then select the polygon next to it, which then selects the ring of polygons. Then delete the ring of polygons. Turn on NURMS again to see the smoothed results. The seat is looking rough. It needs more smoothing. In the ribbon, in the Use NURMS panel, if you don't see the NURMS panel, look for a floating panel somewhere on your viewport. Change the iterations from 1 to 2. Use caution when increasing the number of iterations, not to go too high. The number of vertices and polygons in an object, and thus the calculation time, can increase as much as 4 times for each iteration. This gives the overall shape of the seat more smoothness, but the seat and backrests need to be more straight and flat. But we can't really delete polygons that are going to show as holes in the model. So instead, we need to add more polygons by subdividing. Adding edges that are close together will create a tighter curve when the object is smooth. The farther apart edges are in a model, the looser and rounder the curve will be when the model is smooth. Click the NURMS button to turn it off. In the ribbon, select Swift Loop Tool. The Swift Loop Tool places edge loops by clicking on the mesh. An edge loop is a series of continuous, connected edges. These are important in modeling because having edges that flow continuously around the model creates cleaner, more predictable results, especially when smoothing, such as with NURMS. When you move the mouse over the seat model, you'll see a preview of the edge loop. Move until you have an edge close to the edge at the seat back, and then click to place it. Then create a second near the corner where your knees would be when sitting on the seat, and click to place it. Place a third edge loop along the length in the middle. Turn on NURMS again to see the results. The seat is looking good, but still rough. Go to Use NURM panel again and change the iterations to 3. When the model is selected, go to the Modify panel and name the object seat_geo_003 and then save the 3ds Max file. Open the main train station file. Go to File, Import, Merge, and navigate to the seat file you just saved and select it. Select the seat model from the dialog and OK. The seat will be in the same location as it was built in, which in our case is at the origin point. Select the seat, make sure the Move tool is selected, and go to the Transform Type-ins. Change the X to 800, the Y to 70, and Z to 166. This will move the seat into position on the train station platform so people can wait comfortably for their train.